kickoff here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, presented by Visa, innovation that excites. Both teams are on the field and ready to open things up. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's scrambling, and he's sacked.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
It's second and 12, ball on the 23. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. And he's going to be sacked. Second sack in a row.
Well, this offense is running plays that are taking way too long to develop, giving the defense plenty of time to get after the quarterback. And boy, they're putting a lot of pressure on him.
Third and long now after the sack. To that quickly, and down he goes around the 29-yard line.
Nothing the offense dialed up was enough to get by these guys. They're on right now.
He's taken down at the 42-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. Brought down at the 45-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
He might not be able to get the pass off. And they make the stop right around the 44-yard line. Taken down right around the 46-yard line.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
He throws a dart to the right. Oh, he had a shot at the pick, and that makes it fourth down.
Boy, great defense on that play. They were expecting the pass very well by getting a hand in there to break up.
And they're coming after this punter.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays separation. It out. He's tackled right around the 16-yard line. That'll be a gain of five.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires out to his receiver. They'll bring him down. Dropped it. second down. Tackle made at the 33-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He gets hit out of bounds at the 35-yard line. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out. So the coach challenges the call, and they're going to try to determine if the receiver made the catch inbounds. So the referee calls it a catch, but we'll have a chance to take a second look at it and determine if he really was inbounds when he caught the ball.
Well, the side judge was standing right there, so I'd be surprised if he missed that call.
So the call on the field stands. It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Five wide. And he is drilled at the 35. And the delayed handoff works for a big game.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's in trouble. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain. They come out on an empty backfield. And now he pitches it. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. And he's looking for knocked out of bounds at the 4. So they complete that for about 4 yards and pick up a first down.
Nothing special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. Going right to his tailback. Touchdown, Kentucky! The extra point. So an 8-play, 60-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. Kentucky ready to kick this one off. Sends it center field. Going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. Wildcats are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he's tackled around the 35-yard line. It's second down, and playing the football from the first down marker. They'll work left side. Gains his way to midfield. Going long. Scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's see if things open up in the second quarter. The Wildcats lead 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Gets to about the 17-yard line. From the 17-yard line, it's second down. And they got him for a loss.
You know, it looked to me like he made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. He gets it up, and it is good. Florida State kicked this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Kentucky is up by four. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Taken down at about the 37-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Intercepted.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Quick strike and he drops it.
This quarterback has got to do a better job looking off defenders and allow covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
He's hit and taken down. He punted. No, he faked it. And down he goes at the 46-yard line. Football will change hands as they fail to convert on fourth down. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Got some open field. Gets out to around the 32. That makes us first and 10. From the 32-yard line, it's first down. Tries to buy some time. The ball is loose, and the quarterback comes in and scoops up the fumble. What do you think about that last turnover, Kirk?
Wait a
to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Kentucky is up four. He makes his way to about the 28.
That brings up second and one.
Makes it to the 37. Steps out at the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
And now the ball is loose. And the defense picks it up. And down he goes at the 40-yard line. So the ball will change hands, and that'll be first down.
This guy is about as sure-handed as they come, but fumbles do happen, and you can chalk this turnover up to a very aggressive defense.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need individual video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed. From their own 47-yard line, first down. There's a strike complete. Brought down around the 44-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with the outcome on a first, second down play.
Kentucky holds a 4-point lead. Inside handoff. Runs it right. Nice pickup. Got a man. Watch out here. And they make the stop at the 34. Strike to the back, and he drops it.
Number four was the intended receiver.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Taken down at the 23-yard line.
That's such a huge letdown for this defense. That kind of conversion is just inexcusable.
Kentucky is up by four. Quick out to his receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal. Scrambled. Slides down. He's on the run, and he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. So a 12-play, 72-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And here we go with the offense. Ready to get this going again. And he carries the ball for a nice game. We've played a half. Kentucky leads it 14-3. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Taken at the five. And he just got drilled. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Rifles it right side. This one is incomplete. From their own 22-yard line. Second down. He guns it. Pulls it in, and he could score. To the 20, the 10, and he will score. Hits the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Wildcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's tackled at the 27. That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight. It's second down and eight. Ball on their own 27. Fires it out. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37. That makes it first and 10. Big hit. He's going to lose yardage. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch. That'll bring up second and 11.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on their own 36. They'll spread the field with five wide. Bring him down to the 37-yard line. That'll make it 39. I got him. Check back. Got a man in and out of his hands. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Yeah. gets to about the 37-yard line. Florida State's done everything right in this football game, at least to this point.
Yeah, at this point is a key. We still have an entire quarter to go, but they have executed perfectly on both sides of the ball. They've got a nice lead here. They're thinking about upset.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns in two possessions.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way we've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be living. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
He's out of bounds. At about the 3-yard line. In the open field. Tackle made at the 35.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
Tackle at the 34-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And he is drilled at the 22-yard line. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22. Fires out to his receiver. And he's shoved out of bounds at about the 19-yard line. Tackled at about the 7-yard line.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Ball inside the 10-yard line. Second down. Tackled after a decent pickup. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. What a touchdown. He didn't see anyone open, so he just took it in himself.
This quarterback is fearless, and the defense needs to either spy him or walk the safeties up when they've got the ball down near the goal line.
And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 28-3. The Seminoles are just falling apart in this. Are there any positives you can even use to motivate the team right now?
Well, as bad as it looks and feels right now, there's still over a quarter of football to be played. You just got to forget about the mistakes, try to get a little bit of momentum created, and get confidence back in this quarterback being able to make plays for him.
Zips it to the tight end, and he's taken down around the 32-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. incomplete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gained, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. Brought down at the 37. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Kentucky up by a bunch. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He's at the 30, and they bring him down at the 23. That's three down and one to go. Wildcats are up big. Well, folks, we head into the fourth quarter, and this one is a blowout. They come out in a five-wide set. Just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And they got him.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
He rifles it. It's fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. They're already up big, and this could make the lead bigger. It's up. Looks long enough. And it's good.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
31-3, Kentucky. Looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the 4. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Kentucky's just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
Well, this defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. They've got a nice lead here in the quarter.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Now he's scrambling. And down he goes at the 35-yard line. That's good for gain. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Caught, open field. And they push him out at the 49. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver. And the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Hits him hard at the 40. That brings in second. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's scrambling. Got the corner. He's at the 30. It's a fumble. The defense scoops it. 26-yard line. First down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they make the stop right around the 18-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. Now he tries to buy some time. Inside the 10. Slides down to the ground.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Got his tight end touchdown. He hit the big tight end for 6 on that one.
As a quarterback, you like the tight end inside the 10-yard line because they have a knack for finding the opening. And then you can just drill it in there.
And he tacks on the extra point. The ball is loose. They fall on it. Oh, man. He took him down hard. The Wildcats came out. Man, they were on a mission, it seemed like, from the opening kickoff. They haven't let up.
Yeah, I think somebody forgot to tell them that they're supposed to be heavy underdogs in this game. But they have really shown everybody, you and I and everybody watching this game, they're a team to be taken seriously.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
He's taken down at the 36.
That brings up second and one.
Second and one coming up here. Ball on the 36. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Down around the 33-yard line. Makes it out to about the 20. From the 20-yard line, it's first down. And they'll run him again. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
And the ball game's over. And our final score in this one, 31-10, Wildcats. That wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.